Good morning. In this thesis, we propose an argument related to machine learning applied to communication. In particular, the idea is that given the past quality of communication in terms of packet delivery ratio, so in terms of the number of packets that arrive to the destination, we want to predict which is the quality we will have in the future. We based our analysis on real data that we acquired on a setup we did in our laboratories, and we use artificial neural networks. Like usual, in this video I will introduce the problem in a fast way, and then I will expose some characteristics or some requirements related to this particular thesis. Ok, so the idea, we did a similar thesis related to Wi-Fi, but we decided to extend this thesis to W sensor network, in particular to W sensor network based on the TSCH protocol. Why? Why in Wi-Fi we have a maximum in our setup of 4 channels we can acquire at the same time. Instead, in WSN we have the possibility to acquire sample on different channel, channel 0, 1, 2, until channel 16. So the idea is that in this kind of network we have 16 channels that are in the 2.4 GHz band, and with our setup we can browse all the channel and acquire the characteristic of all the channel, let me say more or less at the same time. So the idea is that we can produce a plot like this, in which we have here time, here we have the packet delivery ratio, and we can see that the evolution of the channel change over times. For instance, here can be something like 45% and so on. Given a window on the past, for instance, the past 30 minutes, the past 1 hour, we want to know, for instance, which is the quality in the next 10 minutes. Why we want to attain this data? Because so at the end we can obtain a similar data for all the 16 channel of my wireless sensor network. So for instance, if channel 2 has this plot, so if at this time we can in some way predict that the quality of this channel will drop on a lower quality, we can use some algorithm that are named black or white listening in order to remove this specific channel. Okay, so we can use this mechanism to predict the quality of the channel. If we predict that a given channel has a quality that drop below a given threshold, we can delete this channel and use only the remaining channel, which are the best one. On the contrary, if I have a channel, for instance channel 11, that has a possible future quality that pass, for instance, from 30% to 75%, we can decide to take this channel that was previously removed and use it in the future, because we can predict that in the future this channel will work in a good way. And we can do algorithm like this one. So we set up a setup composed by two OpenMOT B devices that are small devices that are wireless sensor network, which are battery powered. So this one and this other one of the two devices is the root device, so it is attached to a personal computer, and we configure this slave device to transmit a packet, some packet to the master device in a periodic way in this direction, and we log many indicators. For instance, a boolean value that say if the packet correctly arrived to the destination, or the RSSI, that is an indication of the quality of the channel and so on. So this is our database. We want to apply to this database that was acquired from a big number of mounts, 3, 4 mounts. We want to apply machine learning in order to do this prediction. So, I want to introduce a little bit TSCH, but in a really higher way, because if you see, there are many other videos, so you can browse the video on my channel that speak more in detail what is TSCH, so I don't want to spend too much time in this direction. But in any case, TSCH is a matrix that repeat over time. For simplicity, I represent this matrix with only one row. So the idea is that in TSCH time is divided into slot of fixed duration, 20 milliseconds. So all the nodes are synchronized and divide this time on slot of fixed duration. And this matrix repeat over time. So, and I can use this matrix to schedule transmission. So, for instance, if I have a node 0 that is a root node which is connected to, for instance, my PC that control the network, and I have node 1 that is a slave node, this notation see that I predict the possibility of a communication between node 0 to node 1 in this moment of time. So typically each matrix contains 101 cells. In this case, in order to acquire much data as possible, so here you have, sorry, you cannot see, but there is a PC. In order to acquire much data as possible, we reduce this matrix to only 3 cells, because the first cell of any matrix is used to send messages that are messages to manage the network, for instance, to make the node synchronized in order to see the same view of time and to see the start and the end of a given cell. Then the second cell is used for the scheduling between node 1 and node 0. So it is wrong, because I have to correct it by writing here a communication from node 1 to node 0, and not from node 0 to node 1, node 1 to 0, node 1 to 0, node 1 to 0, and so on. And finally, this other cell is used for the communication in this other direction, because we need in some way to send some control message to communicate to this slave node to start transmission, to stop transmission, and to perform other tasks. In any case, this was a software that was already done by a student, so it can be directly used. So if we analyze a little bit, the dimension of this matrix is 50 milliseconds, 3 multiplied by 20. Each time I have the transmission, the protocol is configured to use a different physical channel. So since we have 16 physical channel, and we can have a communication opportunity every 60 milliseconds, if we perform the multiplication, we obtain roughly 1 second. So with this setup, we pass all the possible 16 channel a time every 1 second. And what we obtain is a database that for each channel, every channel 15, every second, so this dimension is 1 second, as a sample, a boolean sample that say if 1 second, that say if the packet arrive or not. So for instance, here I can have 0001, here 1111010, 0, 0, 0, 1, 0, and so on. And so this is the database that represent if I see this database in this direction, I see the evolution of a given channel. Okay, I see if a given packet at this current time arrive or not. My database, if I take a specific channel, my database at the end is a sequence of Boolean values that represent the evolution of the channel, and this is the past. Then I can take the other Boolean values that represent the target, my target, so what I want to predict. For instance, if I take the Boolean value refer to the 10 minutes, I can compute starting from this value the average, for instance 65, and this 65% is the packet delivery ratio, so the number of packets that arrive correctly to the destination. On the other side, I can make different models. A possible model is to use an artificial neural network to analyze. This is an architecture, but we need to perform a lot of work on these directions. And with, so we analyze MLP, multi-layer perceptron, or LSTM that are typically used for to manage time series like this one. The neural network was trained in order to recognize the 65, but it make an error. So for instance, the prediction of this neural network is 62%, the real future quality is 65%, and we can use, analyze this difference in order to compute an error, and this is the things we want to minimize in order to see if our model works in a correct way or not. So the idea of this thesis is to start from some architecture that we already analyzed and try to analyze in the context of WSN, because all these architectures were analyzed in the context of Wi-Fi. Add new feature, for instance for now we add only this packet delivery ratio. We want to try to add the RSSI in order to see if this quality improve or not, and we have many other idea. For instance, we want to analyze the data in order to see if there is correlation among channels. So if there is a packet loss on channel 1, which is the probability that also on channel 2 there is a loss of a packet? If there are correlated, we can try to see the fact, to manage the fact that if I have a bad channel, also the channel near the bad channel will not behave in a correct way. Otherwise, if there are no correlated, this analysis must be performed separately, channel by channel. And then I have other architecture that I can analyze. For instance, I can have an architecture that provide this probability for all the channel together, so will be a big neural network with a lot of input, and the output is which is the channel that works in a better way, so for instance this one. So in this case we use the neural network for regression. It is not important that you understand at this point why we use a specific architecture and so on, but in this case we use our neural network for classification. On the same case we can use in a similar way like this one, we can use a similar structure for regression. In this case we obtain a probability for each of the one channel, and in this other case we can also perform a rank saying that this is the best channel, this is the second best, this is the third best, this is the channel number 4, and use this information on a pseudo black and whitelisting algorithm in order to detect which is the set of possible channel we can select for transmission and so on. So, you can find in my website sketch.it/ss main information, here referencing one information of another thesis, main information about myself. Remember that if you want to contact, you can write an email without any problem, you can write a Telegram message, or probably better, we can set up a meet, un Google Meet, or what do you prefer. There is also a page related to publications, so here you can analyze if you want my publication in order to understand more or less which is my typical research activity. In any case, from the details related to Wi-Fi, we obtain a preliminary scientific article on this journal, and you can download. Is free, so you can download without problem, and you can download it in order to if it download in order to analyze which is the starting point of these stages. Here you have many formula, but at the end you have not too much formula. But for instance, as you can see here, I try to enlarge a little bit. This is the evolution of a Wi-Fi channel. Here is the packet delivery ratio, so the target 100%. Here you have 15%. You have the evolution of time. In this case, it was a preliminary small experiment that lasts 16 days. And this is our training database. This is our test database. And the idea, as I said, is given a portion of this plot on the past, we want to predict like you do when you analyze action. I don't know, it's not the current name, but when you analyze the evolution of, sorry, of stocks, you want to predict the future. For now, the quality is this one. So, with a neural network, we can obtain an average error of 2%. So, if we predict that the future quality, in this case, in the next 30 minutes, is 70%, the error is 2%, so it can be from 68 to 72%. And as you can see, we compare this algorithm with an average optimized with some optimization, but in any case, you can see that neural network outperforms the quality of this other method we used. In my website, here you have a list of thesis, but actually only the video report new thesis. You have other example of thesis, but are a little bit outdated. Here you have a list of thesis, of thesis, all in this case is outdated, but in any case, if you download here the thesis of Francesco Xia, you have other main information of which is the work we did related to artificial neural network applied to the Wi-Fi channels. Here is a big work, is a good work. So you have the description of the artificial neural network and the software we are using. Now we are using a new version of the software that is better than the one you can analyze here. But in any case, we decided to use the Keras library in Python because typically is the library that is used to manage such a kind of network. In particular, it contains the state of the art of artificial neural networks. So the example of the Keras library are really easy. So here is not the program we are using, but in any case, you can see typically are Python programs in which you use Keras and other things that are pandas, NumPy, that are typically used in order to train neural network, and you have part of the training algorithms. And let me say, and this algorithm can be run if it works. I didn't remember. So, okay, so for instance, now it is reading all the database that are the sequence of 0, 1 and other things you can found is the database we acquired with our setup. And then I think I copy this one for future use. And then if we wait a little bit, there is the starting of the training process that is divided into epoch. So here this is the first epoch. What means epoch? That we cycle on the same data more than one times. If we open this file. Oh no, this is the file on the panda version, sorry. But in any case, at this moment we are acquiring this database, and the database is something like this one on which this is a specific packet sent on channel 9 of Wi-Fi. In this case we have a similar database for WSN. This is a reference related to time. So this is the number of seconds starting from the year 70s of the last centuries. Here is a timestamp obtaining when the packet is sent, is a timestamping obtained when the packet is received, in this case when the ACK frame is received. Here if the packet is arrived or not, and here you have some statistics related to the quality of the channel. For instance, here is the RSSI that cannot be obtained for packet not arrived, and other statistics of the quality, and here is the transmission speed, in this case 54 megabyte per second, is typical. So regarding, so you can you have a lot of material that if you want you can analyze. Regarding the thesis, we have a laboratory. You can perform the thesis on Politecnico of Turin, or if you prefer on Politecnico of Milan. So typically one or 2 days a week I am on Polito, other days I am on Milan, other days I am at home, so you know that it's smart working. So you can decide if you prefer to do it in Turin, or we want to have an experience in Milan. I don't know, depends on the COVID situation if you can do it in presence or not. In any case, I saw that there is not a problem to do it remotely, because at the end, when I link to this cell, I am on a PC, no, not my PC, but in a PC that is located at Polytechnic of Turin. So you can directly do all remotely, because typically we use our PC that are located physically in Turin, or we use Google Machine or something like this. Then, in any case, I want, so it's typically by me that I want to have a meeting 2 or 3 times a week, in the sense that, as you saw in many other videos, I think that only with a strict collaboration can be a positive experience for both you and me. Then, related to the score, I appreciate if you have a score equal or greater than 27, but it is not a strict requirement. So usually I take good students, and you, if you have one or two exams left on your career, so you can dedicate your time on the thesis work. Typically, my idea is that a thesis must be finished in the 6 months devoted to finish the thesis in some situation. So typically, we arrive to 7 months in some situation, eight, nine, but nine is really an upper limit because I think that since it is a work, it must have a start, a finish, and you have to try to finalize the work on the given time. But mostly for you, not for me, because for me, it's not a problem, but I think it's not good if you proceed too much with the thesis, because when you go to work at the end, you have deadline, and I think that in 6 months you can do a lot of work. So if you are constant, typically is the things I required that you work all the day of the thesis, but actually the days, but if you have some problems, it's not a problem. But the idea is that at least 5 hours a day for all the working days, you work on the thesis work. And so if you do this in 6 months, you can do a lot of amount of works. So typically in the first 1, 2 months you have to learn the past things, then you have overlapped, I don't know, 5, 4 months, 4 months and a half on which you can really work on the thesis work, but starting, so the last 2 months must be devoted to start writing the thesis because it's a long work. The thesis I show you in previously by Francesco was performed in LaTeX and in English, but remember that if you prefer Word, for me is not a problem, and if you prefer Italian, for me is exactly the same. Okay, it is not important the language from my point of view, but the quality of your work. Okay, finish. So if you have any question and so on, I'm here. So you have all the contacts, so we can have a meet, or I can reply by mail, by Telegram, as you prefer. Thank you very much.